Hi guys, this is Ranveer from PrintRite. Today in this video, we are going to show you different kind of screens, or we call it mesh, and the uses. So first of all, every mesh or every screen have its number, that is called count. So it is known as mesh count. So in mesh count, it depends on the manufacturer, who manufacture mesh, starting from 120, 150, 155. There are several numbers in mesh. Starting from 50, it goes up to 1200. So there are different types of mesh are there, and different mesh are for different particles. For some garment printing, there are different mesh. For paper printing, there are different mesh, and for plastics, they are different, silicone, they are different. There are lots of surfaces where people used to do screen printing. So every surfaces have different screens. So first of all, if you are a garment printer, in garment printing, there are mostly use open mesh. Open mesh means there are threads that cross per centimeter is less than fine mesh. Fine mesh means their threads are more in per centimeter, per cubic centimeter than open mesh, because in garment you require more ink to be passed. But in that same case, if you are doing a paper, you require very less ink to be passed. So for paper, people use fine mesh. Fine mesh is that your threads counts per centimeter will be more, and obviously your ink deposit will be less. And whereas in garment mesh, the per cubic centimeter thread count is less, so the ink deposit will be more. So, and in some cases, suppose you are doing a CMYK printing, or if you are doing a half tone, or if you are doing a spot color, that time you require the fine mesh for garment printing also. But in basically, if you are doing vector printing, which is the main source of printing, like 90% of your printing job will be vector only. So if you are doing vector printing, that time you have to go for open mesh only. So, first of all, we'll talk about fine mesh. How you will come to know this fine mesh? This will be very hard. You can't stretch it with your hand. It will be more slippery, and it will look like a plastic. You'll feel it like plastic. But it will be a nylon or polyester, but it will feel like a plastic, because the thread counts are more and ink will pass less. And this mesh is more durable, because when you have more threads, means you have more strength in your mesh, so your durability also will be more. Because if you are paper printer, your minimum job will be around 1,000 to 5,000 pieces. So when you are doing 1,000 pieces, or you are doing 25 or 50,000 pieces, you can't change your mesh again and again. You have to stick in one mesh. But in t-shirt, it's not like you will do around 1 lakh pieces. So that's why people use hard mesh for paper and for durability. They want longer durability, because in paper printing, minimum always comes around 1,000 pieces. So in this thing, it is more durable, strength is more, the microns are more, threads are more, and is also expensive than garment printing mesh, because it is for paper. So in fine mesh, you will get it around 255, 250, 230, different numbers. Depends on your manufacturer for where you purchase the mesh. And they are like, this is a garment printing mesh. Garment printing mesh are a little bit soft. it will be soft because the threads are less in deposit more. You remember that thing. So in garment printing mesh, the threads are more and durability is not that durable. It will go maximum 1,000 to 2,000, 5,000 print. So in garment printing mesh also, basically they are called open mesh, as I told you before, but they also have qualities, because some open mesh are stretching mesh, that will stretch more. Some open mesh are non-stretching mesh, they will stretch less, but numbers will vary. This will be around 120 or 130, this will be 160 or 180. Depends on your manufacturer. So while you go for buying garment printing mesh, remember that non-stretching mesh is good for multicolor jobs. If you are doing a multicolor or fine color job, suppose you are doing an India flag, they have three colors together, some type of that multiplex color or something, go for non-stretching garment printing mesh, like open non-stretching garment printing mesh, because that will go for longer time. And you could ask me why stretching and why non-stretching. Non-stretching means the impression will be at once, it will be one time same place. Like suppose you are squeezing up, it will come directly down. Stretching mesh means while you're squeezing, little bit front, it will come. So while you are doing multiple color, it's always advisable go for good quality non-stretching mesh, because that will give you perfect registration in the color, and always use an aluminum frame for that. Plus it will go more quantity. Suppose you have to do 2000 t-shirts or 5000 t-shirts, so go for non-stretching mesh. Or suppose you have your colors are different, because non-stretching mesh is expensive than stretching open mesh. So if you are doing something like let's tell about less quantity and moderate color combination, then you can go for stretching mesh, because this is cheaper than non-stretching mesh. So suppose you are going for 500 quantity or 300 quantity, where you are writing like I love India, it's all are different colors, that time you can go for non-stretching mesh, or like this you can go for non-stretching mesh, or for a small print job. So now you came to know what the mesh all about. Numbers varies from place to place, state to state, so don't go for numbers so much. It depends on your print job, what you are going to do. If you are going to the multiple color job, go for non-stretching open mesh for garment. If you are doing less color, low quantity job, you want a cheaper screen, go for like stretching mesh. That will come in cheap and handy price. If you are going to do in bags, or you are going to for any papers and all, go for fine mesh. And if you are going for CMYK spot color, you can go for fine mesh. So there are different numbers, you can consult us for that. We'll guide you for what will be the best mesh for your printing job, and you'll get all this material in PrintRite. So log into the printrite.com and you can buy it from there. Thanks for watching our video. Do like us, share it, subscribe us, let us reach lots of people. Thank you.